Thottin' and bobbin', thottin' and bobbin', thottin' and bobbin', thottin' and bobbin' it for it all. Ooh, ooh, thottin' and bobbin', yeah. Hello, 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 everyone. Thank you for tuning in. I am Jay Lee. This is Jay Lee's Corner. And this is another edition of Car Conversations on Jay Lee's Corner. Okay. I hope everybody is having a great Thursday. Okay. I hope y'all are all sitting somewhere getting ready to come on the girls, not the girls, to come on the Ooh Ladies First panel tonight at 9:30 p.m. on my channel, okay? Come have a good time with me, Bobby, Niecy, and Jamie, okay? 9:30, Jaylee's Corner, Ooh Ladies First panel, come on through, okay? But besides that, thank y'all for tuning in, okay? I need all of y'all to make sure to subscribe to my channel to become a whole Jaybird, and all that goodness and stuff. But let's get into what y'all here to get into, which is the foolishness that's kind of going on. And because I don't have no time to sit down and do a video, honey, I had to do a car conversation on these things, okay? Because I want to kind of get my fullness of it out and whatnot about some things that's going on, okay? Let's first make sure to also follow me on social media, okay, on IG, J_Lee's_Corner, and on Twitter, J_Lee's Corner. Boom. Links are in the description box below. Let's get into first Wendy, okay? Wendy Williams' show has been postponed again, okay? It was postponed the first time to October 4th or 3rd, whatever Monday that is, okay, because of her COVID-ness and everything. The promotion itself was pushed but was canceled because, you know what I'm saying, she was sick and everything. And just like 2 days ago, Wendy's show had a whole little trailer like, okay, she back on Monday. You don't want to miss it. It's going to be amazing or whatever. That was just, I think, like it may have been yesterday. Maybe it was Tuesday. I don't know. But again, either Tuesday or Wednesday, the whole of promotion thing was saying, you know, the show is fully back on Monday with Wendy's Voice telling us that. But today, they released a video or a statement, not a video, a statement on Wendy's page saying, unfortunately, the show was being pushed back again. Okay? I don't remember what date it's being pushed back to, but like 2-3 weeks from now. But it's saying that she, you know, it's not her COVID situation, okay? That has been, she's tested negative or whatever. It's not that, but she's still dealing with different issues, okay, that needs to be addressed. And so she's not ready to come back on Monday. Look. I wonder, do she need to come back? Do we still need Wendy Williams' talk show currently if she isn't, you know, physically or mentally or emotionally or spiritually ready to do the show? I'm like, I feel like she has like another year for her contract. I was like, man, just pay her out. Or somebody, look, pay whoever out to, you know, not have her be trying to get together to be on the show. Because clearly she's not prepared. Okay, event, you always want, when you are a talk top show host, you do want to go out when you on top. This is a sad way, not a sad way, but an unfortunate way, you know, to open her 13th season, which could be her last season. You usually want to go out on top, okay? How you always are, your full self. You want to get out before they push you out. And not that I'm saying anyone's pushing her out, but I do feel like she ain't going to be the same. Because, again, she has issues that she needs to deal with. So I really want her to go sit down somewhere. You know, give her last season to somebody else, okay? Have the last season be guest hosted by other folk, okay? You know what I'm saying? Do that. Because at least that way the production crew and the workers who work on the show can get paid. okay, they have a steady income and whatnot, and let Wendy sit down and calm down and be that, okay? But we're gonna see what else happens with that, because I'm sure every week or so, it'll probably be some kind of new thing of what's going on with Wendy. Let her sit down and rest, okay? Leave her alone. Anyway, let's get to Mia and Escala. Or does the Housewives of Potomac. Look, last week on the panel, I was like, I am so sick of all this Twitter shit between these people fussing back and forth. It's always something. They should just be quiet and let the show play out. Or if you're tweeting, don't be tweeting at each other. Leave that shit alone. It aggravates my spirit, okay? Because it's like, it's bad enough we have to review the show, which is already dividing folks and whatnot, because who like who cares? But when y'all then go on Twitter, it, which reiterates how someone don't like whoever, it's tiring, okay? So Mia's ass, and y'all know I like Mia. I think Mia is a good addition to the show, okay? I also think Escala is too. I'm like, we don't have to pick between the two, okay? And I think that's what aggravates me, is that people are like, you know, oh, Mia can go, Escala can stay. They both can fucking stay. They both have added to the cast, because how many more seasons can we focus on Karen and Giselle fussing back and forth about nothing, okay? How many more seasons can Robin not do shit besides have blonde hair, okay? So I'm happy that they brought on Mia and Escala, because both ladies have, you know, created storylines on the show or have contributed to the show. So that's my thing. I don't need either of them to go, okay? Y'all know I can't stand Candace. I don't think she needs to leave. I think it's a well-rounded cast. Like who you like who you don't like, but there's no point in saying, oh, someone can go. I was on Twitter last night, and I'm like, why y'all want Mia to go? For what? I don't like Giselle, she ain't gotta go. Now Robin can go. Robin is the one person who can go, because she don't bring shit to the show. Okay, Robin worse than Cynthia, but I'ma leave that be. But Mia was on Twitter, and she called out a scholar looking like Rick James. This is my thing about that. That was funny shade. That was because she did. Look, Rick James' hair back in the day was amazing. But she did have some Rick James hair. It don't mean it. Now, the bad part was the photo she used. She didn't use the right photo. You didn't show Rick James. You should have put a Rick James photo from back in the day. That would have been funnier, because it would have been true. Her hair did look like how Rick James' hair looked back in the day. But to me, that wasn't, like, mean. I'm like, it was funny. Giggle, giggle. Okay? Because, again, it's shady shit. But she also brought up how, you know, Escala hasn't shown her family, hasn't shown her house or whatever, how she lived with her mama, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, oh, why you bring up mamas? You want to talk about mothers? I'm like, I really want folks to stop bringing up people's parents, okay? Y'all are all too old to be fussed about anybody else's parents, okay? There's no reason in a shady context that anyone should bring up anyone's mother, okay? Leave it be. But I also get Mia saying, you supposed to be so fat with your mama later. I'm like, Mia, just don't, because you don't want anyone going in on your mama. So Mia, leave that shit alone. Okay, leave that shit alone. Now, a scholar clap back saying, first of all, bitch, I am fabulous and my mama lived with me. I don't live with her. She came to live with me to help me take care of my kids, okay? Because my mama loved me. Unlike your mama, okay, we ain't all out here working on our relationships with our parents. And I was like, ooh. This is the thing about that I'll say. Had a scholar said that in scene on the show, fine. Like when Candace said, you know, your mama, whatever. I'm like, okay, cool. But it's different when, you know, you've seen the strain between them two and you bring it up. So it's like, oh. But I'm like, again, Mia brought up the mama first. So, you know, you can't say you're not getting done back to you. So it's the weird thing about, stay off fucking Twitter, Mia. Everybody stay off Twitter, okay? Get off the tweets. Anyway, but when Mia then came back, and I'm a boss ass bitch or whatever, you know what I'm saying, blah, 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 and who needs a babysitter when they don't do shit? I said, oh, now she don't do shit. You don't work, so why you need your mama help? I was like, girl. But I think a scholar issue, and she got two kids under two. But whatever. Mia then came on like the day after and saying how, you know, she had been having somebody else in her tweets. She had like a, you know, a social media handler or whatever who was going too far in what she was saying, what they were saying. And so she let that person go when she's looking for somebody else to handle her social media. And she apologized for the things that were tweeted. Now, this is my thing. Some folk don't believe her. I don't care either way. But I also feel like if y'all don't think these celebrities sometimes do have other folks handling their social media, you a fool. If I could hire somebody to post for me on my social media, I absolutely would. But I don't trust people. That's the thing. You have to trust the person enough to let them handle your social, because whatever they tweet, it's going to go back to you. They're going to say you did it. So I don't think she's lying, but she could also be lying. But I'm like, it's not far-fetched that somebody, you know, may have somebody else who know about Twitter or whatever, or can do, or can always be talking shit, handling their social media. So I don't know, but I can appreciate her at least saying, you know, sorry, even if she passed the buck to somebody else, whatever. Okay, love, light, or whatever. But again, Mia throw shade, she do. But the whole show, they all shady. It's the weirdest shit to me that people don't like her shade. Like, I don't like Candace and shade, because Candace and shade be rude as fuck. She go too far, but she know that. But that's Candace, okay? I'm like, I don't mind anyone being shady. But I'm like, sometimes y'all should just know, okay, maybe y'all shouldn't, you know, do this and do that. But again, it's all a learning experience. But again, I don't want Mia or Skylar to leave the show. Okay, I feel like if you add them to the show next season, have them both be full-time housewives, you will have a more well-rounded cast. Okay, because again, Robin don't do shit. Wendy had time to be born too. Her candles ain't made. Okay, asking the fucking kids and that Michael whatever. So you do need some more people in here to create some friction, and that is what Mia did this season. Like it or love it, or like it or hate it, that's what she did. Like it or hate it, Candace also do the same shit. So it's like you can't, you know, it's I don't know. I like the fact that it's a well-rounded show. I'm like, but whatever. Let's go. You know, Bravo supposedly wants to bring NeNe back to kind of cover or wrap up the thing about, you know, Greg passing away. You know, NeNe and Greg was on the show for so many seasons. It almost makes sense, but it also doesn't. But I also feel like NeNe's issue before was like she felt like they was pushing her out, paying her less money or whatever. And so it's like, and after what she said about them too, and how that worked, would it make sense to bring NeNe back in any capacity? I'm not sure. Now, would I mind if they, you know, have an episode or two where the girls go see NeNe or whatever, check on her? Because again, Greg and NeNe were a big part of the show. So I wouldn't mind it, but I don't really want NeNe back in any kind of full capacity, because NeNe will always come back feeling like I'm the HBIC because I was the originator. I don't want that energy on the show anymore. But I don't mind them wanting her to come back just to have that part of, you know, the Bravo franchise legacy, whatever. They still wanted to honor Greg in some kind of way, because Greg was a big part of, you know, Bravo and the show, and everybody loved Greg. So I don't mind that, okay? But that's just me. But I'm my girl, whatever. Now, we talked about Kenya, okay? Kenya, who is now on Dancing with the Stars. I have never watched that show in any real capacity, but she's on it this season. I heard she's doing very, very well. But they're saying that she had to choose between doing that show or doing Bravo's Housewives, okay? Because it's kind of filmed at the same time. Candy has said over the years that when they are trying to do other things, sometimes Bravo does not allow them to do it. If it's being filmed at the same time of them doing their show. I feel like that's because if you are away filming on a show or whatever else, it means you can't film for them. So I get them saying, okay, well, no, you can't do that, because again, we are shooting our show, and their show is supposed to be about what they're doing together, but not if they're going to be gone on set for 3 months. You know what I'm saying? So I get that's hard. So it do depends. I don't think, because Kenya doing the show Dance with Stars, she not in Atlanta, so it would be hard for them to shoot her away doing whatever, so it would be less, you know, showtime. So I get it, but that's the price you pay when you own a certain show. You know, you have to figure out, you know, schedules and shit. So it makes sense, even though it seems unfair. But that's like, yo, if you work one job but you have to go to another job, you can't do that. You know, your job don't want you somewhere else when you're supposed to be working with them. So that's where I think it came from. But again, she doing a show now, so if she gonna film better, fine. Martell Holt, who was on social media, Martell posted the names of the men he's accusing Mel of having an affair with. I mean, he posted, I'm like, and I'm not gonna say it here, but again, we may discuss that on the panel tonight. But I really feel like Martell is consistently saying shit and doing shit that we don't believe. So I be trying my best to not even give it any energy. Where the fuck wouldn't you go? Why would you not? Girl. Anyway. But yeah. Martell post stuff and say stuff that I don't believe ever. Because he make up shit. So it's stupid. Mel had to then do a rebuttal. Okay, or reply. Saying she has never, ever, ever messed with anybody who was, you know, married or had a fiance or whatever. So what he said is a lie. But I'm like, we know that. I really don't see Mel. The fact that Mel was so distraught over her husband cheating on her, I don't see her doing that with other folks. Now, what Mel consistently does say in response to Martell saying she cheated is that anybody I dealt with after April, whatever day that I left my husband, moved out and never moved back in, anyone after that date is free game, because at that point I had left my marriage. Okay, so I may have been legally married, yes, but I was done with my marriage. So you can't say I was cheating on you. I had left your ass. Okay, so that's the most that she say about it, and I believe Mel. So I'm like, Mel probably was fucking with somebody after she left Martell, but it's the thing is, when she had left Martell, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, Martell, shut the fuck up and leave it be. But that's all I have for y'all right now, because I'm pulling into work. All this construction is a bunch of bullshit. Okay, why is there so many cars outside my girl, why is all these cars here? Where's all these people coming from? Car drive. Anyway, have a good Thursday. Again, I hope to see all of you tonight on the Ladies First panel. We'll be live, and then Kella or whatever. Oh, it is like everybody's here. What is this about? Anyway, yeah, gotta go. Peace.